One of the problems with the VLOOKUP function is how information is pulled through by making reference to the column number in a table of information. The problem with this is that if changes are made to the spreadsheet, these column numbers do not adapt for that, and as a result, it can be very time consuming to correct all the functions, or even worse, errors can be generated through ignoring the effects of the changes. In this segment, you'll learn a technique to make it easier and safer to make changes to a spreadsheet that has VLOOKUP functions in it. In this example, we have some information with regards to students, their student number, and their marks achieved in recent exams. What we'd like to do is build a little lookup section where we can type the student number in and all the information will be pulled through. To do this, we'd use the VLOOKUP function. So if we activate the function wizard, go to VLOOKUP, the lookup value is going to be the student number, and because we're going to copy it across, we want to anchor it so that it stays looking at column A. So we'll just put in the correct dollar sign. It needs to look at this table here. And again, we make absolute references. Because we're looking for the name, it's column 2, so we type in 2. And we want it to be false because we want to find an exact lookup, and you click OK. We now hit our first problem, because if you want to now take this function and copy it across, because of the way the formula has been set up with a hard-coded reference to a column number, all these cells will now look at column 2, and what you'd prefer is if the surname looked at the surname column, which is column 3, etc., etc. So unfortunately, you need to manually go through and make the changes. There's also another problem. What happens if you've forgotten to put, for example, the English mark in, and you click here, you insert a column, and you put the English, and we'll just put a marking for this person. What you'll see happening down here is the maths mark is coming up here and it says pull through column 4. If you go here 1, 2, 3, 4, the maths mark is pulling through the English mark. So unfortunately what it would involve again is going here, copying all the way across, and then setting up the column numbers again. A way around this is to do the following. Above the data table, write the column number in the relevant cell. So for example, in your VLOOKUP, this will be column 1, so you put a 1 there. This will be 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now when you build the VLOOKUP function, you do the following. Again, going through the function wizard. The lookup value we point to, and we're going to make it an absolute reference on the column. The table array, we highlight the table we're looking at and we make it absolute reference. And the column index number, instead of saying number 2, we refer to the cell here. And the range lookup again is false, and we say OK. Now, when you want to copy the cells across, what will happen is each VLOOKUP will actually look at its own column and find the number in there. So what is important now is that these numbers accurately represent the column they are in. And that way, with one move, you can copy across the entire row and get the VLOOKUP to be working. What happens when you insert a row? Well, if you insert a row in the same place, and it's the English mark, and we'll just put an amount here. You'll see that it is still the same problem, because what is happening is it has been told this number here says look at column 4, which is 1, 2, 3, 4. But now instead of having to change everything here, you can just copy this one across, and then you just make sure that this is correct. So you just update this. And there we have the VLOOKUP sorted out. Now obviously for this small example you could have done it on your own, but when you use hundreds and thousands of VLOOKUPs, this will save you a lot of time and just make the whole process a lot safer. Just as an aside, you may have noticed that the average did not change when we put this number in. The reason for this is because we inserted a column right on the border of a calculation. So for example, this is an average calculation looking at those two. Because we inserted the column here, it was not included. And this is how easily errors happen in Excel. It's important to be very careful when you're inserting columns or rows.